In this video, we'll take a look at how to optimize your video metadata on YouTube to make your video more discoverable and show up more in search results. Hey guys, how's it going? This is Serge and welcome back to my channel. Last week, we took a look at how to upload your video to YouTube directly from Final Cut Pro, and today, we'll learn how to optimize your video metadata to make it more visible. I'll go through all the steps I take to make my videos as discoverable as possible. If you want to skip ahead to a specific step, I'll leave time codes in the video description. First thing you need to do is go to youtube.com and sign into your YouTube account. Next, click your channel icon in the top right corner and select Creator Studio. On the left-hand side, select Video Manager, find the video you want to optimize, and click the Edit button beside it. Your title and the video thumbnail are a couple of the most important parts because that's what gets people to click on your video, so we'll focus on them first. The title should include keywords people search for related to your video, but make sure to optimize it for people. The video I'm optimizing today is a Tiny Planet tutorial, so Tiny Planet is a keyword I'm targeting, but I need to make my title a little more descriptive. I'll name mine, How to Make a Tiny Planet Video Final Cut Pro Tutorial. Make sure your title describes your video but doesn't deceive people. If someone searches for how to make a tiny planet and clicks on my video, they expect to learn how to make a tiny planet video. If my video doesn't deliver, people will go to the next one right away. This sends YouTube a message that my video is not delivering what was promised, and it will stop showing up in search results. The thumbnail is the first thing people see after they search for a video. By default, YouTube grabs a couple frames from the video and shows them as thumbnails. Majority of the time, this looks bad, so people will just scroll by your video. To make your video more attractive to viewers, you should make a visually attractive custom thumbnail for your video. To set your custom thumbnail, click the Custom Thumbnail button on the right side of your video and select the one you made. Same as your title, do not try to deceive people with your thumbnail. This sends the wrong message to YouTube and your video will suffer. Next up is the video description. You have a 5,000 character limit for the description and you should use that to your advantage. Enter a short or a long description of what your video is about. Make sure to include the target keywords, but still, optimize it for people, not just the search algorithm. You can make your description box bigger by clicking a dragon in the bottom corner. The video description is also a good place to add any social media links, links to stuff you talked about in the video, or any other links your viewers will find helpful. I have a template for all my links I add to the video descriptions, I just copy and paste into my videos. The box under your video description is where you add any relevant tags to your video. Add keywords or key phrases here people might type in when searching for a video like yours. YouTube doesn't place much weight on the tags, but you should still add as many as possible, up to the 500 character limit. Over on the right hand side, select your video's visibility and whether you want your video to go public right away, unlisted, private, or scheduled. The last option lets you pick a date and time your video gets published. If you select Scheduled, two more boxes appear underneath where you can set the date and time you want your video to be published. If you're part of YouTube's Partner Program, you can monetize your video by selecting the Monetization tab and turning on Monetize with Ads. YouTube will place ads before, during, or after your video, and you will receive a small percentage of the profits YouTube makes. After you entered all your info, click on the Publish button in the top right corner. Next up is video end screens. YouTube lets you place interactive elements during the last 20 seconds of your video to keep the viewer watching your content. Just make sure you don't place this over any important content in your video. Turn on the preview toggle and play through the last part of your video. When you're ready to add your end screen elements, pause the video and turn off the preview toggle. Click the Add Element button. Here, you can promote another one of your videos or playlists, add a subscribe button, promote another channel, or add a link to an approved website. For my example, I'll add a link to another one of my videos. I'll select my video and click the Create Element button. An interactive element card will show up on my video and I can adjust the placement of it by dragging it in the viewer. I'll add another link to a playlist and a subscribe button. Another way to add interactive links to your video is by adding cards. These are the little pop-ups you see in your video and is a great way to link to other videos related to what's going on in your current video. To add a card, play your video and pause it in a spot where a link to another video would be useful. In my video, I referenced one of my previous videos, so this will be a great place to add a card. Click the Add Card button and select the type of card you want to add. You can now add a custom message or modify the teaser text shown with your card. Just like everything else, make this relevant to your video. Click the Create Card button. To preview this, scrub back in your timeline and press play. Your card will pop up in the top right corner of your screen with a teaser text your viewers can click on. I'll go through my video and add a few more cards. All these tools are designed to help keep your audience watching your videos, which sends a good message to YouTube and make it more likely to recommend your videos to more people. Adding closed captions to your video will also help you reach a wider audience and help with your video's discoverability. When you upload a video, YouTube automatically transcribes it, but in my experience, this can be very inaccurate. To add your own captions, click the Add Subtitles or Closed Captions button and select Upload a File. Navigate to your captions file and click Upload. After your file is uploaded, click the Set Timings button, and this will sync your captions to the audio in your video. This may take a couple minutes, but after your timings are set, make sure to go back and unpublish and delete the auto-generated captions. The last thing you can do to make your videos more discoverable is add hashtags to your video description. YouTube lets you add up to 3 hashtags to your video descriptions, and I normally place them at the very bottom. These hashtags will show up as clickable links above your title. When someone clicks on one of these, they will get a playlist with other videos using the same hashtag. This is a new feature, so I'm not sure how effective it is, but it can't hurt anything, right? Adding all this metadata to your video is not necessary, but it will help make your videos more discoverable and will help you get more views and hopefully subscribers. What are some of the tips and tricks you use to help your videos get seen on YouTube? Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, let me know by hitting the like button. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.